Well, they don't have much power right now, certainly not in this country. But look at the history of where real change has come from. The Shah of Iran thought he'd be the Shah forever, and people came in the streets and overthrew him. It's debatable what came next, but mass struggle, when the people were decided to change things, they did. The same kind of force brought down Mubarak in Egypt, the same force brought down Marcos in Philippines. The same force has elected progressive governments in Latin America. Yes, ordinary people in their millions, with some sense of unity and some vision to fight for, they can shake things to the very bottom of the soul of a system. I think the elites know that. The elites know how powerful people could be, which is why they spend so much money in this country on corporate media to try to make people feel ineffective. They target their leaders. Their people that have emerged as leaders of mass struggle have been assassinated in this country, or have been jailed, have been framed for various things and thrown away, thrown into jail with a key thrown away. People have been infiltrated. Now there's tremendous amounts of spying going on, electronic surveillance. The thing the elites fear most is an organized people. And so they do everything they can to cause disorganization, to weaken that. But history has shown, humanity has shown, we got out of the Dark Ages. Every critical step in the whole evolution of our species, human consciousness has come to the fore. People have sacrificed and waged struggle. And there's no reason to think humans have changed that character. That's one of the things they try to convince people of, that humans are inherently greedy, that all they really care about is themselves, no change is really possible. If that was true, there'd be no humans anymore. So we, if you want to say, we have faith in that, and I think the evidence bears that out. So yes, we think change can come from ordinary people. We also think it's critical in the scheme of that change or that process that we need to build a space in the media that creates a platform for people that allows people to discuss and debate how to wage that struggle, but based on facts, not based on a lot of rhetoric. There needs to be a media platform that can investigate what is really going on. For example, in Baltimore, why have 50, 60 years of government policy completely failed in alleviating poverty, which is what they were supposed to do? At the same time, billions of dollars have been invested in places like the Inner Harbor and other kinds of development, convention centers and such, that were supposed to have such spillover effects that it would reduce poverty in the city. But after years of these kinds of programs, quite the contrary, poverty has greatly increased. So this change needs a media platform that will answer that question, why these policies have failed. But even more importantly, a platform where people can discuss, debate, investigate, work out in detail what policy really would work. How would you reform the school system? What would you do with policing? What would you do with unemployment if you had a government in Baltimore at the city level, at a state level, where the only agenda was the well-being of the majority of people? What does that policy really look like? So that's our role. Our role is to not just to report and not just to critique. We need to go beyond critique. We need to go to what will come next? What will people fight for? Because we think if we can capture a big piece of the media audience in Baltimore and later in other cities with that kind of vision, then we think it's a game changer.